Hematocrit is a key diagnostic parameter in medicine that looks at the ratio of the volume of red blood cells to the total volume of blood in a given sample. It is expressed as a percentage, and it provides crucial information about the oxygen-carrying capacity of the blood, as well as various physiological and pathological states. We created this video to cover the medical definition and provide a brief overview of this topic. So if you're ready, let's get into it. Hematocrit tests are commonly ordered as part of a complete blood count, a standard blood test often used in medical evaluations. The hematocrit value is primarily determined by two factors, the number of red blood cells and the volume of plasma, which is the liquid component of blood. A normal hematocrit range varies among individuals and depends on factors such as age, sex, and overall health. In adult men, the typical range is approximately 41 to 50%, while in adult women, it is roughly 36 to 44%. However, these ranges may differ slightly depending on the laboratory and methods used. Hematocrit levels outside the normal range may indicate a variety of medical conditions. For example, a high hematocrit value may be indicative of conditions like dehydration, polycythemia, or lung and heart diseases that result in low oxygen levels. On the other hand, low hematocrit levels may suggest anemia, malnutrition, leukemia, or other blood disorders. Variations in hematocrit levels can also be influenced by lifestyle choices such as smoking and environmental factors such as high altitudes. The test itself is straightforward and minimally invasive. Blood is generally drawn from a vein, usually from inside of the elbow or the back of the hand. The blood is then placed in a test tube and centrifuged, separating the components by density. After centrifugation, the red blood cells settle at the bottom and their volume is compared to the total volume of the blood sample. And this ratio gives the hematocrit level. Hematocrit values are critical in making clinical decisions, especially in scenarios like trauma with substantial blood loss, monitoring of chronic conditions like kidney disease and anemia, and preoperative evaluations. Additionally, athletes and mountaineers often monitor their hematocrit levels as it can significantly influence physical performance. Hematocrit levels that are too low can result in insufficient oxygen supply to tissues, while hematocrit levels that is too high can lead to increased blood viscosity, possibly resulting in thrombosis or tissue ischemia. But as you can see, hematocrit is a significant diagnostic metric that provides valuable insights into a person's overall health and ability to carry oxygen through the bloodstream. It is commonly used in a wide range of medical contexts, from routine checkups to emergency room assessments. Understanding hematocrit levels can offer key diagnostic clues and guide healthcare providers in making informed decisions regarding the treatment and management of various medical conditions. If you want to support the channel, please like and subscribe. I would greatly appreciate it. And there should be some other helpful videos popping up on your screen right about now that I think you will enjoy. And just a quick reminder, we are not doctors. This video is for informational purposes only. Thank you so much for watching. Have a blessed day. And as always, breathe easy, my friend.